Hello guys, welcome to this next lecture of CRUD operations using Spring Boot and Angular application. So in this series we are basically giving focus on CRUD operations, and as a backend we are using Spring Boot and as a front end we are using Angular. So till now we have completed all the functionality like this create, that means this registration of the student. Then we have already seen how we can show all the details to the table, and we have already seen how we can delete the records. Now the only functionality we left back is with this edit, that means update operation. So in this video we are going to see how we can create these REST endpoint for this update operation, and probably in the next part we will see how we can use that REST endpoint in this Angular application. So let's see how to do this. Now I'm in my Eclipse IDE, and over here we have created this student application in the previous lectures, and we have already seen how we can configure this application so that we can use database into it, and we have added all the dependencies, and we have already created the REST endpoint for register the student, then get all the information about the students, and then delete the student details. So let me go to this src /main/java, and inside this you will find this package called as a controller. So let me open this student controller, and over here we have already created all these three REST endpoints. So let me just add one more method so that we can create one more REST endpoint for update the student. So let me add public, it will return the updated student details. So let me give return type as student, and the method name will be like update student, like this. Now this student method or this particular REST endpoint will accept all the student details, or we can say that the details of student which needs to be updated. For example, let's say the address of roll number 1 is a Pune, and that Pune needs to be changed at the Mumbai. So these details I need in this method. So let me accept student as a parameter, like this. Now let me open these curly brackets, and over here we have just promised that we will return the student, but we are not returning anything as of now. So let me just return null as of now. So this line will get need to be removed after some logic, but as of now, to just remove this error, let me return null. Now over here let me give the mapping. So mapping for the update will be the put mapping, and path of that endpoint will be like update student, like this. Now over here we have just passed the student parameter, but remember that this is not a particular, or this is not a extra, or this is not ordinary method in the Java. This is the REST endpoint. So we just need to use some annotation called as a @request body. So this is why, because we are going to pass all the student details through the body of request. So we have already seen how we can pass the details to this register student, and over here we have already used this request body annotation. So in similar way, we just need to use this request body annotation for this. Now our controller is ready, so we just need to go to the service package, and inside that we also need to configure something. So let me go to the student service.java, and over here let me add one more method. So over here public student, then method name will be like update student, and it will also accept the student details which is passed by the controller. So let me add this parameter, and let me open the curly brackets. And over here it is also giving me some error, because we have promised that we will return the student, but we are not returning anything. So let me just, to remove this error, let me return the null, like this. Now this error is vanished. So let me write some logic, and I will try to explain what I am writing exactly. So over here let me write some logic. So let me first of all fetch the roll number from the student. So student.get roll number, and the roll number is integer, so let me save it to the integer variable. So integer roll number, is equals to student.getRoleNumber. Now we just need to find all the details of existing students. So I will explain. First of all, I will write the logic and then I will try to explain the logic. So let me write a student repository dot find by ID, and the ID will be this roll number. And this particular find by ID method will return us the student. So let me save it into this std variable, and then over here we just need to write one more lines. So let me use this, and as of now it is giving me error because the find by ID method does not return student exactly. It returns the optional op student. So we just need to get, or we just need to fetch the student from that particular optional. So we just need to type, or we just need to call one more method, get over here. So don't worry about these get and all these things. If you are beginner, if you don't if you don't have much more knowledge about the Spring Boot, so don't worry about this. In my upcoming courses I am going to explain each and every thing in details. So now our student is ready. So let me update the details. So how I will update. So std.set name, and inside this what I will do, student.getName. I will try to explain each and everything, so don't need to worry about this. So let me write the logic first so that I can explain you. Then student dot set address, and inside the brackets we just need to pass the address. So address is a student dot get address, and student dot set percentage, and here I think I just need to pass over here student dot get percentage. And now we just need to save this particular student. So how we will save? Student repository dot save, and entity will be std. And what we will do, we will just return this saved entity. So let me return this saved entity, and over here we have returning the value. So we just don't need this return null. So let me remove this one. Now our service logic is ready. So let me now try to explain what is happening over here. Now I'm on my whiteboard to explain this update operation. So let me try to explain what is happening over here. So what we are doing, if you observe in the update student, we are just taking the details of student which needs to be updated. So what we are doing over here, we are just taking one object from the student, object from the user, and this will contains new values of the student. So new values can be like a name, address, and percentage. So let's say I just want to update the address. So let's say I will pass the Mumbai inside this, and over here this will also contains the roll number. So why this will also contains the roll number? Because already we have registered the student, and that particular student will have the roll number. So let's say the record which we need to update is having roll number 1. So what we are doing, actually we are fetching this roll number from this object, and we are asking the database like, hey database, please give me the details of roll number 1. So what database will do, database will find the details of roll number 1 and it will give me the all the details. Okay, so database will give me the all the details of roll number, and inside these existing record or the database record, let's say address is Pune, right? And address is Pune in the existing database record. And what I want, I just want to remove this Pune, and I just want to put this new Mumbai value instead of this Pune. So what I will do, I will just put the new Mumbai value over here. So now if you see over here inside our coding, what we are doing in the service layer, we are just taking, or we are just finding the roll number, and over here we are just asking the database. Hey database, give me the details of role number one. So database gives me the details of role number one, and we are just storing those details into the std. And what we are doing, we are just removing the existing values and we are just setting up the new values. So what we are doing, we are just setting up these let's say in, for example, as I shown you on whiteboard, we are just taking the Mumbai and we are just setting it as an address. So this is how this logic is going to work. So don't need to make it very complex, just keep it as simple as we can. So I just tried to explain the logic behind it over here inside this whiteboard. Now our REST endpoint is ready, and let me go to the controller and let me show you how it is. So mapping is put mapping, and the path is a slash update student. Now let me try to hit this particular REST endpoint through the Postman. So let me go to this com.youtube.student application, and inside this it is having the main method, so that let me run it as a Java application. So run as Java application, and let me wait a couple of seconds so that it will start running. And now over here the application is started running, and the application is running on port 9090, so it might be different, like 8080 for you, because the Tomcat default port is a 8080, but I have configured this Tomcat to run on 9090. Now let me go to the Postman and let me try to hit this REST endpoint. So let me add one more tab over here, and the path will be like localhost, port will be like 9090 slash, and let me try to copy that particular path. So let me try to copy this update student. Let me go to the Postman again and let me paste it over here, and the mapping is put mapping. So let me select the put mapping, and from the body we are going to pass all the details. So inside this body section, so you will find different sections, so we just need to select the body, and inside this we just need to select the raw, and inside the raw we just need to select JSON. And now let me try to create one JSON object. So over here I have already one snippet of JSON object while registering these students, so I will just copy that one. So if you don't have, you can create this one. So let me copy this one and let me paste it over here, and remember that this name, address and percentage must be the same that we have used in this model object. So we have already created this model object, and we have all these properties of the student, like name, address and percentage. So remember that these spellings and all, and these variable names must be the same like here you are passing. Okay, and one more property that we need to pass is the roll number. So let me type roll number, and let me give roll number as a 1. But over here in a database I don't have any records, so let me cancel this one. So I don't have any records because my database table is empty, and I don't have this roll number 1 inside it. So first of all, before updating, we just need to make sure that we have all the details. So let me hit this get student rest endpoint. So we have already seen how we can create this. Let me send this request, and as you can see over here, it is giving me the empty set. So first of all, let me try to register. So I will go to this register student rest endpoint, and I will keep these details, and I will send these details. And over here you can see student is registered. Now the roll number of Raj is 1, address is Mumbai, and percentage is 97. So let me try to change this Mumbai from the Mumbai to Pune. So let me go to my new REST endpoint, and over here let me pass the address as a Pune, and let me send the details, and let me wait a couple of seconds. And over here as you can see, I got the status as a 200. Okay, but what I was expecting, like it will send me the registered student details and all, but over here we forgot one most important thing. So let me go to this database Eclipse IDE, and over here we have created inside this service, we have created this, you know, update student method, but we are not calling this update student method from the controller. So if you remember, I'm just returning it as a null. So we just need to call that update student method. So let me call student service dot update student, and we just need to pass this student over here, and let me return this because my service is returning me the student, and that particular returned student I will return from the controller. Now it looks good. So let me go to this student application again, and let me stop the running and let me restart the Java application. So run as Java application, and let me wait a couple of seconds so that it will start running. And now application is running. So let me go to the Postman again, and let me register one student, because as soon as I started the server again, all my database values got vanished. So I will tell you the reason why all the details got vanished, but I will not make it this video very complex. So let me register this student again. So let me send the details over here, and as you can see, the Raj is registered. Now let me try to first of all get the student. So let me hit this get endpoint, and over here if you see, the Raj is present in the database. So let me try to change this Mumbai to Pune. So let me try to we have now already seen how we can create the JSON and all. So let me try to hit this REST endpoint, and now over here it is passing me, returning me all these updated values. So updated value is name is Raj, address is now Pune, and previously it was Mumbai. We have updated this Mumbai to Pune. Now this is all working very fine. So let me go to the database quickly and show you whether it is actually working or not. So let me open this MySQL client, and let me put the password. So my password is root, and it will authenticate, and let me use my database. So my database name is student dashboard, and now let me select star from student. So we already seen how we can create these tables and all, and over here the address is Pune. So let me again hit this REST endpoint, and let me change this address and percentage this time. So percentage I will make, let's say 50%, and address will be like Kolkata. So let me go to this update student, and over here let me change this percentage. So the percentage will be the 50%, and address will be the Kolkata, like this. Now let me send the details. Now over here, if you see, we are getting the response from the API. So let me go to the database quickly, and let me again select star from student, and over here all the things are updated. So address is now Kolkata, and percentage is 50%. So this is how we can create one REST endpoint to update the details. Now we have created this REST endpoint. In the next video, we will see how we can consume this REST endpoint from the Angular application. So from the CRUD operations, we are now almost done, and only one thing is left back, that is consuming this REST endpoint from the Angular application. So I will show you in this upcoming video. So if you do not want to miss that particular video, you need to subscribe to my channel. So thank you for watching this video, and subscribe to my channel, Learn Programming Yourself.